Genomics has a tremendous impact on agriculture and has transformed the way we produce almost everything that we eat. It's not just putting genes into plants or animals in the laboratory the way we think about when we think about GM organisms, but it actually involves the use of high throughput technologies to determine the genetic constitution of the animals or the plants that you're selecting for example, improved yield or disease resistance. Traditionally, this selection of desirable individuals has been based on what they look like. You know, is the plant tall? Does it look like it's healthy? Does the bull look a particular way? And so it's always been a question of assuming that whatever the organism looks like will be determined genetically, and that you can then take the advantage of their appearance, of those visible traits, and select for those traits and hope that the genes go along for the ride, if you will. But genomics has completely changed this. Now you can look directly at the genome of organisms using very high throughput technologies and select the individuals that have particular genes that control the traits that you're interested in. So this technology depends upon knowing which genes control which traits. So it depends upon that sort of background information, which has also been determined by genomic studies. So how is this done? In the case of very many companies, for example, have very sophisticated tools for doing this. They have what are called gene chippers. So thousands of seeds are fed past a robot. It picks up the seeds automatically, brings it over to something that looks like a table saw, and then actually chips off a piece of the seed. It orients the seed so that the saw will only chip off the part that's not going to kill the seed. It takes that little bit of plant material, automatically extracts DNA from it, a DNA analysis is done, and then that information and the identity of the seed, of course, is connected with that information, is then put into a large database that a breeder can then screen, select the desired seed, plant in their field, and then use for their crosses. In dairy, the dairy industry has also been transformed by this kind of technology, where now individuals that produce high-yielding daughters that produce lots of milk, can be selected based on their genotype and not just based on their appearance or even based on their parents, as their lineage, as it's called, as has been done in the past. So traditional breeding has been transformed by these genomic tools, by information about the genes that control various traits, to do things on a scale and at a speed that was previously unimaginable.